Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and especially the Glentoran volunteers, welcome to this very special event. My name is Pete Snodden. I'm a radio host. I love Irish League football, and it's a great honour for me to be here today to share this very special occasion with you. The Oval has witnessed many special days, but I'm not sure whether it's witnessed as special a day as today, because today is a recognition of the tremendous work being done by you here at Glentoran. I was first brought here as a nine-year-old. My dad was from East Belfast. He grew up in Newcastle Street, and then they moved to the Braniel. So he played football, and I'll just move this up a wee bit. I'm not the tallest person in the world, but whenever you have to put the microphone up, you do. He brought me here at nine whenever I showed an interest in the game, and I loved it and got a new hero, and that was Billy Caskey. And he was great in the ball, loved how he controlled midfield, and he brilliant passer of the ball. He was also a hero of mine off the field because he once let my friend Graham and I into the cinema for free, and I loved him for that. Anyway, today I'm here, and I'm delighted to host the event, and we're going to celebrate all the amazing work that is done here at Glentoran at the Oval. And I suppose loosely on behalf of all the fans, because there's people out there who live and breathe this football club more so than myself, but on behalf of all the fans, thank you for all your hard work. I'll just do that right from the start, because today is all about you, because if it wasn't for the hard work and effort that you put in here to this football club and the community, the football club would not exist. So today is the day we've been looking forward to, and the official presentation from the Queen's representative this afternoon, Vice Lord Lieutenant of the Borough of Belfast, Sir Nigel Hamilton. In a moment, you're going to be asked to stand to receive our very special guest.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on this very special occasion for Glentoran Football Club, may I invite you to welcome the Vice Lord Lieutenant of and for the County Borough of Belfast, Sir Nigel Hamilton, accompanied by your club chairman, Mr. Stephen Henderson, escorted by the Lord Lieutenant's cadet, Sergeant Major Ryan McMaster of the Adjutant General's Corps, led on this occasion by Piper Jane Cook. Please rise.
They come under a lot of pressure. I don't think that the average fan, suppose like myself, has any idea of the work involved. In preparing for today, I have discovered that at times these guys, all volunteers themselves, can be involved with Glentoran issues up to and over and beyond 40 hours in a week. So as a recipient of the award in his own right, and to open proceedings, can I welcome the chairman of Glentoran, Mr. Stephen Henderson.
My sort of lieutenant, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, as the chairman of one of, if not the largest voluntary organisation in East Belfast, it is with a huge sense of pride that I welcome you to the Oval today for the official presentation of the Queen's Award for Voluntary Service. Today is another auspicious occasion in the 136-year story of Glentoran Football Club. Today, Her Majesty bestows upon you, upon us, the most prestigious award available for a voluntary organisation. From the dawn of our existence in Queen Victoria's reign, when Belfast was but a mere town, through to the present day, Glentoran have been embedded in the East Belfast community. For many of the millions that have passed through our gates through those years, we are rightly regarded as one of the most successful football clubs on this island. That success has led us to travel the world representing our country. And yet we have never lost sight of who we are or where we are from. In an era of post-industrial decline and the difficulties of adaptation to a new world order, our club has become the last remaining icon of East Belfast. The Queen's Award for Voluntary Service recognises the impact you have had and continue to have across all sections of our community, in East Belfast and beyond. Delivering based upon minimum wage calculations, significantly in excess of £1 million worth of voluntary work each year, you have impacted positively upon the lives of so many. From the youngest members of our society to the oldest, from the newest arrivals in our country to the least fortunate, delivered for us by you in our name, irrespective of faith, ethnicity, gender or ability, all have been and will be welcomed here. But the question for many from looking from outside is why? Why would you sacrifice so much of your personal time to help this club and to help our community? Certainly not for monetary gain. Indeed, arguably not even for glory in recent years. But for most of us, if not all, the answer lies closer to home. This club, our club, the part that we all play in it, is about fathers and mothers, grandparents, uncles, aunts, cousins, sons and daughters. This club means so much to us all because of those who have gone before and for those that we wish to follow after us. It's about family. It's about friends. About the collective memories of the shared good times and the collective amnesia about the darker days. We do this because we can, because of this community and this club's immense pride in East Belfast, because while there are arguably easier ways to give back to our society, nothing else can ever be so personal, so special, than honouring the memory of those who went before us. By keeping this club alive and vibrant, by keeping this club relevant and at the heart of East Belfast, as she begins to get back on her feet and dust herself down. When the Oval was destroyed on the 4th of May 1941 and the dark clouds surrounded the club's very existence, it was our community, our supporters, our volunteers who brick by brick, inch by inch, built this club up again from the ashes. That sense of giving, that pride in our name, the desire to build something better, something real, something lasting, was embodied in that wartime generation. It still exists today and is gathered right here in this room. So for once, stop today, look around, think about what this ceremony represents and congratulate each other and yourself. This is your day, your award. This is Her Majesty the Queen recognising and bestowing upon you the Queen's Award for Voluntary Service. On behalf of Glentoran Football Club and the thousands of people whose lives you have touched and enriched, I will leave you with two words that we never say enough. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Okay, Vice, Lord Lieutenant, Deputy Lieutenants, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, in a moment, I'm going to be having a quick chat with some of the representatives who do so much vital work here at the Oval and in the community. But before we get to that, we're going to take a look at a short video right now, which really captures the heart, and everything that is Glentoran football club.
Glentoran football club was founded in 1882.
Okay, so quick, since we're standing where we are, pub quiz. What year was Glentoran founded? whilst we get to that, let's have a chat to some of our very keen volunteers whose work does not go unnoticed. I'll call you up two at a time. So first and foremost, from the Milk Bar and Special Appeals, Jody Killips and Norman Turnahan from the award-winning Gazette. Norman, we'll start with you since you've got the microphone, although we normally do ladies first and all of that, but sure, you double job, so you've got the job of this gentleman as well, was a teacher at my school.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I didn't know that. A few years ago. You never taught me. So obviously you've got to keep the board in check as secretary.
That's right, yeah.
And how difficult the job is that? Don't over elaborate.
It's not too bad, but I must admit, since I took the job on, it makes me realise how much work does have to go on behind the scenes. You know, we are a part-time club who are run by volunteers, and but we are under the same sort of red tape and bureaucracy as a full-time professional club, so it's a huge task to keep this place going.
And when it comes to the Gazette, how much work goes into that? Because you just don't turn up on a Saturday to see it.
No, well, there's a huge team of people go at produce the Gazette on a Saturday. Like, we've got our designer, Clifford Logan. We've got all our contributors, the writers, the photographers. I sort of just put all that together. And last but not least, there's the guys who sell it on a Saturday. Like, people talk about them standing out in the rain and in the hail and the snow selling the Gazette. But as well as that, people forget that they also miss a lot of the game. They're in counting the money after a kickoff, and so a lot of the time they miss the first half. So there's a real team of people that are behind what you see being produced on a Saturday.
I appreciate that you've got a lot of people who contribute to it, but since you put it together at the end, you have overall editorial control.
Yes.
Yeah, so how difficult is that?
It's not really difficult at all. There's nothing too controversial goes into it. No fake news.
Jody.
Yes.
So, tell us about the Milk Bar.
The Milk Bar is a place where you would come for tea and coffee, your pie, your sausage roll before the match, half time, things like that.
And how much has it changed over the years, and actually to get that title, the Milk Bar?
Well, it's very family oriented because we're attached to the family stand, so. The bar is the bar and we're the Milk Bar, so you come to us for the non-alcoholic drinks. So.
What's the atmosphere like down there on the Saturday? You know what it's like up here? It's buzzing up here. What's it like down with you?
It's really, really good, really busy. So it's great. The kids and all come in. And it's a good family place and we just sit and all chat and get on.
And in terms of the work that you do there, how much do you enjoy it?
Oh no, we love it. I have a great
you
team.
You said no fake news?
No fake news. We have a great team. I have Alistair and Claire who are hiding down at the back, who give their time during the week and the day or so beforehand, we get everything set up. We don't get to see any of the football, which is quite hard for us, but we enjoy doing what we're doing. So.
And away from that, you're very much involved in the special appeals, particularly around Christmas.
Yes, we were very involved in the homeless appeal, not just at Christmas, but Christmas would be the highlight for the football club where we do.
So tell us a little bit more just about all the appeals that you do and your role specifically in them.
Well, my role is just kind of just trying to put it all together, but with the help of everyone else. I mean, we couldn't
don't hide your light under a bushel. No,
we couldn't do what we do without the fans. I mean, every year we ask the fans. We started off with just doing for the homeless, and over the last couple of years we've realised that homeless, they're very unfortunate, but there's also a lot of unfortunate people within the East Belfast area. We didn't realise just when we started off how many old age pensioners were on their own on Christmas Day, and maybe no family or families that were hard up. So each year the appeal is growing, and this year, to say it is going to be phenomenal. We are doing hampers for as many people as we can within East Belfast. We're inviting old age pensioners to the Oval for their afternoon tea and a trip down memory lane. And we're also going to have disadvantaged children here. We're going to have a cinema day and our own Glentoran Santa coming along. And then to finish it all off, we will have our gifts and we will hit the town and walk about the town to hand them all out and go to all our... We'll go to about four or five different homeless shelters, and that will be us, hopefully, at the end.
Amazing work. Congratulations. Jodie and Norman, everybody.
Thank you.
Stephen Laurie from the Glentoran Academy, Gail Redmond from Glentoran Women, and Stuart Malcolm from the Maintenance Men to join me. Right, so the club always needs players. So tell us a little bit about the academy, the structures you've got in place, and the success that you've had.
Well, I was looking back on some records there just this week for a project that we're working on, and I came across our old membership list when the academy first started in back in 2008, and saw that we had 75 players on our books in that first season. We now have over 500, so it goes to show you how much the academy has grown in that space of time. That includes now the country's only Polish academy. And a girls' academy and disability academy, so we cater for all sections of the community.
So obviously you can't do this on your own, so you've got a lot of people who help you. So how big is the team?
Yeah, we've got, in the boys' academy alone, we have 88 coaches, and I'm sure maybe Gail will touch on how many coaches they've got in a wee minute, but overall, coaches-wise, we have over 100. To run all sections of the academy, and certainly whenever I'm trying to organise things during the week and maybe asking for help from the guys, it just dawns on you really could not do it. It just wouldn't exist without the coaches and the help that you get. Whenever you put out an appeal for help, the answer is always yes, and how can we help, and it's amazing.
And what's it like for you and your team whenever you get a player, through, be it into the first team here or to go further afield?
That is the ultimate trophies. You know, it's an old cliche that in youth football you shouldn't judge on trophies and medals and winners. The trophies are the kids who develop and come through into the first team or beyond, and lately we've had great success in that. One little lad, Ethan Warnock, joined us when he was 7 years old, and he's just signed as a professional for Everton. And Christopher Collins signed for Burnley, same circumstances. So those really do give you a particular delight when that happens.
Well, Stephen, on behalf of everyone, thank you for all your hard work. Many congratulations and keep it going. Give a big round of applause. Right, Gail, you've got 10 minutes to tell us how the women's team beat the Blues. Congratulations. Was that the highlight of this season by a stretch?
Yeah, I think, you know, when you were planning the season ahead, you know, getting to a final was up there, and we wanted to compete in the league this year and really go for it, and we did that as well, so lots of highlights.
In terms of the women's side of the club, what's the atmosphere like at this moment in time, and judging by the cup final, I think with what you achieved, you made a lot of people raise their eyebrows.
Well, that's good. You know, again, we've been going from strength to strength as a club, embedding the women's team and the academy together. And I think for us, moving forward, and I just really want to publicly thank Jodie. Again, just goes to show how much of a club, you know, we are moving forward. She would do the food and stuff for the girls as well. And so, again, highlights like that with our media team, and you've seen on social media how far we've come. But in the sense of just as an achievement of the Irish Cup, you know, we want to win more trophies. One just isn't really good enough for us. And again, you know, it's been a couple of years since we've won the league, and that's still going to be our main focus for next year.
There's been an awful lot of focus just in football in general about bringing the women's game on, and you guys are doing a great job here. And how proud are you of you and your team to add to that? Moving forward in terms of raising the profile of women's football here?
Yeah, obviously, again, I probably wear two hats since it is my job, but again, just even this past week, we have three girls from Glentoran that's competing with our under-19s for Northern Ireland. So again, women's football is now being recognised, it's being highlighted, and hopefully that will continue on with this club.
Gail, many congratulations.
Thank you
very much. Stuart? What can I say? The Maintenance Men sounds like a rock band.
we're all a bit old for that.
Now, again, don't hide your light under a bushel. Before we start, tell me all about Michelangelo.
What a guy. Anybody who comes into the Oval will see Trevor's work as Michelangelo as we know him. Stand still for too long, you've had it.
Tell us about what you do on a daily basis and a weekly basis, because I would imagine, having been around here for quite some time, you're kept busy.
We are kept very busy. We come down here at least once a week to generally tidy up after the games, do maintenance about the place that we can do. We have a good band now. We have 8 or 9 of us now who come down every Monday. Doesn't matter what the weather is like, rain, hail or snow, we're here, we're down in the summer as well, doing the maintenance, and good bunch of lads who work really hard here. We really are pushed at times.
What do you get out of it personally? What makes you keep on doing it?
My love of Glentoran Football Club. I've always been a Glen man from I was no size, and it's great magazine. My son is with the academy, and my grandson's at the academy, so what more could I ask for?
Well, listen, keep up the amazing work that you do, you and your team. Ladies and gentlemen, Stuart Malcolm. Pop quiz. Do we all know what date? Yes, we do. Let's get to the video.
We have 127 senior trophies, including 23 league championships and 22 Irish Cups, the most recent in 2015. We were the first British club to win a European trophy, the Vienna Cup in 1914. That cup is still proudly displayed in the trophy cabinet in the Oval boardroom.
My name is William Kirkwood, and grandson here at Glentoran Football Club. This is me into my third season now in charge. I've been a Glentoran supporter all my life, so when I was offered a job, that was an easy question to answer. To be doing this job personally is an honour for me. I haven't supported the club all my life, and being even just being able to walk on that pitch and boot is, you know, it's a privilege for me anyway.
My name is Jodie Phillips, and I'm a volunteer here at Glentoran Football Club. I'm also the supervisor and manageress of Glentoran Muff Bar, which is our muff bar that people come to before and during the match. I also am responsible for the charity that we do every Christmas for the homeless. This year we're working with Haven, the local community, and a couple of the homeless hostels in Belfast. Haven being our main one, who we're going to be going out to their feeding stations and actually providing food and serving the food to the homeless and less fortunate.
Five Northern Ireland managers have played for Glentoran, including the current incumbent Michael O'Neill. In fact, on the four occasions when Northern Ireland have qualified for major tournaments, we have been managed by a former Glentoran player. 42 players have been capped by Northern Ireland for the Republic of Ireland while with the club, and we have played 98 matches in senior European competition.
My name is Jimmy Carter. I'm the chairman of the Glentoran Sports Committee in 1923. I've been a member of this club from 1981, joined when I was 18 years of age. My father was in the club before me and my uncle. We're the oldest Glentoran supporters club, but also one of the oldest supporters clubs in the British Isles. We're best known for producing the match day programme. We've won the Northern Ireland programme record award 14 years in a row.
I'm Ruth, I run the Superstore. We give supporters the opportunity to buy all the merchandise. I also deal with the season tickets for supporters. The third main priority is I look after the gift of fish for the players.
Our stadium is in the heart of East Belfast. It has played host to many of the greatest names of European football. Juventus, Ajax, Rangers, Paris Saint-Germain, Benfica, Arsenal, Marseille, Basel and Borussia Mönchengladbach have all come to the Oval to compete in European competitions. All have gone home remembering the tough battle they had with the part-timers from East Belfast. Glentoran and East Belfast are synonymous. One without the other is unthinkable. There are many great days ahead for us in a rebuilt stadium we can all be proud of. This year, Voluntary.
You knew all that anyway. It's just great to see that. And the one thing that I get every time I come here, from the fan base and everyone who goes to represent this club, be it in a volunteering capacity or on the pitch, is how much pride they have in the football club, where it stands within the community, and the great work it does both on and off the pitch. We're now going to hear from the coordinator of the Queen's Award, a man who is no stranger to getting awards from the Queen. He has an OBE. Nor is he a stranger to East Belfast, having grown up in the Bloomfield area and was involved in youth work in the Sydenham community. Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause please for Mr. Walter Radar, OBE.
Well, Lieutenant, Deputy Lieutenants, elected members, distinguished guests, and I think particularly today, volunteers of this great club. In particular, in case we forget later on, let's give the volunteers, and the volunteers give themselves, a very good round of applause. I'm delighted, first of all, to bring you greetings from the Queen's Award United Kingdom Committee, and congratulations in particular from our chairman, the broadcaster, Sir Martin Lewis. You may know that Martin was brought up actually in Ballymoney, has maintained his interest in all the nominations from Northern Ireland, and in particular asks me to convey, Chairman, to you, his congratulations on this achievement today. Today really is rather special, because what we're doing today is actually writing history. You only ever get the Queen's Award once. So we'll not all be gathered here next year, or 5 years' time, or in 10 years' time, to get the crystal and the citation. So you are writing history, and that history is being streamed live by your own television channel, so that everybody who can't be here today is joining in with this celebration. I hope afterwards you will have the opportunity to look more closely at the logo of the Queen's Award, and you'll see that the crown is made up of figures of small people. And it is said when the design was mentioned to Her Majesty, she was quite taken by the notion, because she liked the idea that volunteers were going to be at the very heart of the award that she instigated some 16 years ago. You can't nominate yourself for the Queen's Award. And I am particularly grateful to the nominator, Maurice Kincaid, for putting forward a very clear and a very concise nomination of the outstanding work that we've heard about Pete as a result of your chats to folk and that film. The breadth, the scope, the extent, the skill, the imagination, the passion, the enthusiasm is there in bucketfuls. And it's so nice to see that. One of the wonderful aspects of the award,
I was told to say that by the way,
is Vice Lieutenant, as you know, when our Lord Lieutenant dispatches some deputy lieutenants to come down and have a wee chat with the management and the volunteers. Some people are in fear and dread, some people quite like it, but afterwards generally the response is, it was good to be able to tell our story. It was great to be able to put the points across, and it helped us to understand, because you guys live with it all day, every day. It was good to have an opportunity to tell your story to somebody else. Those deputy lieutenants then have to write all that up, and the Lord Lieutenant herself is constrained to 600 words for her citation. And I have to tell you, when that arrived with us in the London committee, and we looked at that in February of this year, it was very evident to us that there was information about the quality, the calibre, the passion and the enthusiasm of volunteers that was second to none. Because we've had the assessment locally, here in East Belfast. My committee members and I are then looking at these at a United Kingdom level. And we have a rather clunky phrase But it says, what are we looking for? We're looking for evidence that the nominated organisation demonstrates that it is going above and beyond that which you would normally expect from, in this case, a football club. You have now joined 120 organisations across Northern Ireland over the last 16 years that have been awarded the Queen's Award, of which there are only three sporting clubs, and that includes you today. I'm sorry to have to admit this, Chairman, but Ballinamallard United got there last year. The other group, and I trust you're impressed because I had to learn this for their presentation ceremony, the other sporting group that got it was the North Armagh Motorcycle Brackets Tarmac Section and Car Club Limited. The fact that I even remember that is a miracle, to be honest. We all know them better as the folk who organised the Tamdragee 100. And you now join those three groups as the only folk from the sporting sector who have been nominated for the award and been granted it. So I think there's a message for anybody out there who recognises the work being done by sporting organisations, to which I would also have to add history and environmental organisations, about nominating for the Queen's Award in the future. It ain't a foregone conclusion. This year, Chairman, we had 445 organisations across the whole of the UK who were nominated. Assessed locally, assessed at a United Kingdom level. As a result of that UK assessment, we felt able as a committee to suggest, recommend to Her Majesty that she would be graciously pleased to grant the award to 240. So the mathematics of that, I will leave to others, it's about just over 50%. And I know our Lord Lieutenant wouldn't forgive me if I didn't say, and Northern Ireland tends to do a wee bit better than that every year. So we were closer to 60%. It's still a massive achievement. And it's been achieved because you, the volunteers, make this daily contribution, Pete, that you have outlined, that the volunteers talking to you have outlined, and that the film sets out so clearly for us. It has been said on many occasions that volunteers are ordinary people who do extraordinary things. You are doing those extraordinary things. Congratulations, and keep on doing it. Vice Lord Lieutenant, may I invite you to address the gathering today and then to present the Queen's Award for Voluntary Service to Glentoran Football Club. Mr. Chairman, fellow Deputy Lieutenants, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's an absolute privilege and a pleasure for me to be here today representing the Queen and representing the Lord Lieutenant at this very, very important occasion. I should let you into a small secret that in my teenage years, I used to come and stand on the terraces very regularly. In fact, I told the chairman that I was here one evening when Glentoran were playing in the old Intercity Fairs Cup. If you're old enough, Bob, to remember that. And Glentoran were playing Borussia Mönchengladbach. And the chap on the PA system said, "We're very pleased to welcome till the Oval tonight, Borussia from Germany." "We're very pleased to welcome to the Oval this afternoon, all of you." Can I just say three things very briefly? Firstly, this is a prestigious award. As it says here, it's the equivalent of an MBE for voluntary groups in the sporting sector, in the charitable sector, and in the community sector. And it's extremely, the bar is very high, as Walter has just explained, in terms of assessment and in terms of getting through the process. I'm delighted this afternoon that Nigel Carr is here, because Nigel, who you may know, played another game
many years ago. And Nigel is one of our deputy lieutenants who actually did the assessment. I'm also delighted that Judith Eve, one of our deputy lieutenants, is here as well. I'm glad you said, Walter, that the assessment was good, because Nigel Carr did it and Nigel Hamilton wrote it. That's a secret. The second thing I want to say is simply, well done to all of you who volunteer. I know someone's done an assessment that every year something like 70,000 hours of voluntary work is given to this club. That's tremendous. And the theme, of course, is our club, our community. And from what Pete and others have said already, you're in the community from under six to frail elderly, across the community, in all communities, on a volunteering basis. And that is absolutely tremendous. You're making a huge difference to lives in the community out there. And I don't think anyone will ever appreciate the legacy which that will leave in terms of the individuals who you're helping and who you're supporting. And the third thing is, I know, because I've spoken to a number of the volunteers earlier, I know the passion and the commitment that you bring to that job. I just hope this afternoon that having received this award, you can leave with pride and satisfaction. It's not a fault to be proud. I think it's something that's very important, that you can be proud and you can be hugely satisfied with what you're doing. And as the chairman said in his opening comments, thank you for your kind comments, Stephen. Keep doing that, because that is what will benefit everyone in this community and beyond. Thank you very much for the opportunity to be here, and very many congratulations on the award of the QAVS.
Thank you very much, Sir Nigel. Okay. Vice Lord Lieutenant, Deputy Lieutenant, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, to receive the award on behalf of the volunteer community of Glentoran, I would ask the following people to come up and join us at the front. Firstly, to receive the Crystal Award, Ruth McCreary from the Glentoran Superstore, and Club Secretary Ricky Ray. And to receive the citation, Graham Norris from Finance, and Trevor Taylor, or as he's fondly known, Michelangelo. On behalf of the fans in the greater Glentoran family, let me be the first to congratulate everyone involved in winning this accolade, and I think it deserves a massive round of applause. Round at the front, by the way, gets to come to all the prestigious events. So thank you very much for your attendance today, young man. Thank you very much. So Nigel just whispered at my ear. I hope I got the name right. Yep, excellent. First class. Okay. This afternoon, folks, can I introduce Colin Jess, Vice Chairman of Glentoran, who will officially respond to the award. Colin is a relatively recent conscript, volunteer, to the board, and I think it's fair to say he has had a baptism of fire. Colin.
Thanks very much, Pete. Yeah, it's been an interesting year and a half in the board of Glentoran, but one that I'm immensely proud to be part of. My role today is a very pleasant one. It's just to round up and give a set of thanks and thank you to certain people. Vice Lord Lieutenant, Deputy Lieutenants, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to thank Sir Nigel, who has honoured us here today with his presence, and for presenting this fabulous award. Sir Nigel, I know, asked specifically to come along today because of his connections with the Glentoran Football Club, and for that we're very thankful. I'd also like to put on record my personal thanks to the Deputy Lord Lieutenants. First of all, we met Philip McGarry and Courtney Thompson in Knock Golf Club to kick the process off. Then we met Judith Eve, and I have to thank Judith. Judith, we met, came along to the Academy Open Day last year, and I know that you've been impressed by what the club has been doing, so thank you very much. On probably the coldest January evening, we had Nigel Carr and Garth Corbett. I don't know if any of you are here on a winter's night, but the temperature in this stadium in this, on a winter's evening is, I think it must be near minus. So to thank them very much for staying for some time as well, and for their listening, it's very much appreciated. To Cadet Sergeant Major Ryan McMaster, thank you for coming today and the part that you have played. And a special thanks to Walter Radar, for guiding us through this whole process. I probably met Walter a few years ago in my day job. But when I came to Glentoran and I noticed to see just the amount of volunteering which went on within this club, it was very clear to me that this was an award that we could have applied for and had every possibility of obtaining. So perhaps you could all join me in thanking those people that I've mentioned for the part they have played in getting us here today. I'd like to thank three special contributors today that have got us to this point as well. Mr. Morris Kincaid from East Belfast Partnership, who acted as our nominator and nominated the club officially. Morris can't be here today, but he sends his congratulations and best wishes from the USA, where he's on holiday. Sam Robinson, who provided personal support, and that of Glentoran Community Trust, another passionate band of volunteers. And especially to Mr. Ewan McKibben. Ewan is a 21-year-old fan who attributes his progress from being a struggler at school to entering final year university in Leeds with being involved in the academy as a coach. So thank you very much for all those guys as well. Thank you. I'd like to thank Pete Snodden today. From the moment that I mentioned to Pete at one of our games earlier this season, he says, absolutely, Colin, anything I can do to help. Pete, we're eternally grateful for you for coming along today. I must admit, when my phone rang this morning at about 10 o'clock, I was slightly concerned that something had cropped up, but true to form, he was just confirming details and what time he needed to be here for. And I know Pete's been very busy. It's been a very busy week for him, and he's busy this morning with work, so I appreciate you, Pete, taking the time to come down here today. So thanks very much to Pete. I'd like to say another thank you to our special guests who are here with us this afternoon, and for so many of them turning out to Glentoran Football Club for this occasion. Your presence here today, councillors, Gavin, our MP, and MLAs, is immensely encouraging to us as a management group. As you can see, the club is having an immense impact around East Belfast and further afield, and we are delighted that you're here today, and we appreciate your support, and also that we will be bringing initiatives forward in the next few weeks and months, and that we trust that you'll be receptive to what we're saying and what we're trying to do as a club in Belfast, East Belfast. Thank you. Finally, but not least of all, on behalf of the President, David Schick, who's here with us today, Chairman and Board of Glentoran, a huge thank you to each and every one of you. Without you, there would be no Glentoran, at least as we know it. Without you, we wouldn't have 600 young people associated with this club, wearing our club colours every week. Without you, we wouldn't have a stadium that, despite its age, still stands proudly as one of the last icons of East Belfast. Without you, we wouldn't have a Glentoran family, some of whom are spread around the world and can't be with us here today. So thank you very much, and I'd like to offer the applause to you guys as well. We've just got two more items to deal with. As recipients of the award, you are entitled to wear the Queen's Award badge as a symbol of your success and your contribution to Glentoran Football Club. It's a badge that you should wear with pride and with honour. So immediately after the ceremony, we're delighted today to have Elliot Morris, who passed 700 appearances for the club a couple of weeks ago and is our longest serving current player with us today. And we're also delighted to have Jess Foy, the captain of our ladies team, and as you know and heard, our recently successful Irish Cup winning team, will be downstairs at the door of the McLean suite. So as you go in there, we invite you for a cup of tea. We'd like you to go in and receive your badge from Elliot and Jess downstairs. So make sure you don't miss that before you leave. The chairman has also asked on this occasion, when we have the elected representatives here, if you could possibly meet us just straight after this for 5 to 10 minutes in the boardroom, just for a quick chat. We'd be delighted if you would do that. Just pass your way through into the boardroom before heading downstairs. So, Vice Lord Lieutenant, Deputy Lieutenants, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for being with us here today and sharing on this very special occasion, an historic day in the life of Glentoran Football Club. Thank you. And can I just, the final thing is, can I ask you all to stand as the official party leave the room? Thank you. Thank you.